This video is brought to you by SeedProd. In this video, you'll learn how to uninstall and delete a WordPress theme, and we'll go through it step by step. So some of the main reasons why you want to delete the theme that you're not using on your WordPress website is because the files are written in PHP, and if they're not being kept up to date, then malicious code can be written in them, and people can come in and hack your site by having themes that you're not using on your site. Also, keeping them installed on your server increases the backup file. So removing the themes from your site that you're not using reduces the overall backup size of your site. And then also, it's just a good idea to remove any of them so you don't have to worry about keeping them up to date if you're not using them. So let's take a look at the area first. First, you want to go to your WordPress dashboard, and let's go to Appearance, Themes, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. First off, there are three themes that are installed on this particular site. This one is the active theme, meaning it's the one that is being used, and these two aren't being used at all, but they're on our server. So it poses somewhat of a security threat, and then also it's just a maintenance headache. So let's go through the process of how you can successfully and safely delete any themes without worrying about messing up your website. Now, if you've done some maintenance or if you've done some customizations on any of these themes and you want to save them before you delete them, an easy way to do that is you can just log in either through an FTP or with your file manager, with your hosting provider, to go and do that. And I'll show you how you can do that. So you can log into your hosting account and go to File Manager, and you'll want to go through to your specific theme location. And then from here, you'll see WP content. You want to double click on that, go into themes. And from here, these are the three themes that are available to your website. And if you go here, you see that that's what those are here. What you can do is find the one that you don't want to lose your customizations for. If you want to download it, you'll first want to compress it, give it a name, compress the file. And now you have a zip file that then you can download. Once you have the theme backed up and off of your server, then you can go in and delete it. I'll show you a couple ways that you can delete it. First, let's go back to our WordPress dashboard, and we're under Themes, under Appearance, Themes, and any of these that we aren't actively using on our site, if you click on it and go over here, then you can safely delete this. And you can do the same thing with this one if you want to. Now, another way that you can delete it, there are two other ways that you can delete it. You can go into your file manager, find the one that you want to delete, and then highlight it and click delete. Same thing if you're using an FTP client, you simply go to this location, find it, and delete it from there as well. And now, if you accidentally deleted a theme, then there's a few ways that you can restore it. First, you can restore them from the backups that we just did or from the copy that we just downloaded. But if you didn't make any backups or if you didn't copy them, then you'll just need to go out and get a fresh copy of that. For instance, let's head back over to our themes area. Say we deleted the 2020 and we want that back. We can click add new and we can go in, and if it's in the repository, then we can simply search for it. 2020, this is the one that we deleted, but we want it back. You can go ahead and click install here. Now, there won't be any customizations that you created. They won't be with that new installation, but at least you'll get the theme back as you need to. Another great thing to have for your website is by using SeedProd. When you're just starting out and you're designing the theme that you want, then get and install SeedProd. SeedProd will allow you to do a coming soon page for your website while you're working on the back end. With SeedProd, you can also do things like collect email, let people share your website out with social media profiles, and it allows you to really drive home some anticipation and some excitement for your website while you're working on it on the back end. To get started, just head over to seedprod.com and make sure you use promo code WPBVIP to get the best discount on SeedProd. And thanks for watching.